வணக்கம். வெல்கம் டு அவர் கோர்ஸ் ஆன் எஸ்ஏபி ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பிளானிங். இன் திஸ் செஷன் வி வில் பி டிஸ்கஸிங் அபவுட் பிளானிங் மெட்டீரியல் அண்ட் பிளானிங் பிளான்ஸ். திஸ் கோர்ஸ் சோ ஃபார் வி டிஸ்கஸ்ட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பிளானிங் அண்ட் ப்ரொடக்ஷன் டைப்ஸ், வாட் இஸ் ஆர்கனைசேஷன் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர், வாட் த டிஃப்ரெண்ட் மாஸ்டர் டேட்டா ரெக்யர்ட் ஃபார் எஸ்ஏபி ப்ரொடக்ஷன் பிளானிங், பேசிக் அண்ட் பர்ச்சேசிங் வியூஸ் ஆஃப் மெட்டல் மாஸ்டர், MRP 1 and 2, all the parameters. Then in MRP 3, we discussed the parameters in forecasting and planning strategies. And last session, we discussed the consumption mode and consumption period. Now we are going to discuss about planning material. So what is planning material? Why do we use the planning material? There are different ways to use the planning materials. One of the ways we'll explain now. For example, we are having a toothpaste, right? This toothpaste may be produced in different SKUs. For example, TP1. With a 50 grams size, TP2 with a 100 gram size, TP3 with 150 gram size. When we want to plan the materials for this toothpaste, these raw materials, then by entering all these individual metals, it may be a lot of time. And also when you're entering the sales plan for these materials, putting together all these plans individually, it may be difficult for a sales team. They will tell this is a toothpaste. For example, per month, we are going to produce 100 metric ton or maybe 1000 cartons or 2000 cartons, like they will say. At that time, we will plan this based on this toothpaste, which is the virtual material, right? We'll be using as a one material will create like a toothpaste. In that, we'll be link all these TP1, TP2, TP3 materials. So when we plan this toothpaste, all the raw material required for this toothpaste will be planned individually. When you receive order for this individual SKUs, they will consume this plan of this toothpaste. That's how it will be working, right? Let us see that how this is executed in SAP. So we are having the field called planning material. So when planning with planning material strategy are used, this field can be used to enter the planning material. So planning material is a virtual material. It may not be a real one. The demand will be entered for this planning material. So, and also the materials like a TP1, TP2, TP3 are linked with this planning material in this MRP3 view. So when you receive sale order for this material like TP1, TP2, TP3, they will consume the plan of this toothpaste, the planning material. So this will work along with the planning bill of material. We will create planning bill of material for the toothpaste, right? How to create planning bill of material? Those things we discuss in session 22 when we discuss about the ATO strategy, right? This is mainly used for a push-pull mode. That means, based on the planning materials BOM, we'll buy all the raw materials, then keep in stock to produce the toothpaste. Based on the actual orders which are coming for individual SKUs like TP1, TP2, TP3, we'll be procuring the packaging materials, right? So there is a push with respect to raw materials. There is a pull with respect to the finishing the products. That is a planning material. Planning plant is the plant associated with the planning this material. And also this is where the planning material, where we need to have the goods shipped. Then planning conversion factories, if there is unit of measurement which is different between this planning material and the actual material, we can use this factor here, right? Now let us come back to our toothpaste and this TP1, TP2, TP3. So now these TP1, TP2, TP3 individual materials are linked to the planning material in MRP3 view, right? If MRP3 view of TP1, if you take, the planning material will be toothpaste. If you take MRP3 view of TP2, planning material will be toothpaste. Like that, it will be entered there. So we are creating a link. Now for the toothpaste, we'll be creating the planning bill of material, where it will be having all these raw materials like fluorides, abrasives, flavors, humectants, detergents, caps, like this. At the same time, we'll have a production BOM for this TP1, TP2, TP3, where it will be having its packing tube, primary packing and secondary cartons. So using the planning material, we'll be, and through planning BOM, which we will discuss in session 22, we'll plan all the raw materials in advance and keep there. So now the actual orders for TP1, TP2, TP3, now the packing materials will be planned, right? So how these materials will be linked together, right? So here we are linking them, how the plan will be working. So for example, let us see this plan, right? Week 4, we are on plan of 500. In the first week, in the week 4 itself, we are getting an order for 50 numbers of TP1. So it will consume the plan of 50, remaining plan will be 450. Next, we are receiving an order for TP2, 100 numbers. It will consume this plan of remaining 450. So balance plan will be 350 of toothpaste, the TP. Okay. Then we are receiving the TP3 order of 150 numbers. Then that will be consuming. So remaining plan will be 200. So A common plan of toothpaste, which is 500, now it is formed with these individual orders from TP1, TP2, TP3 for these 50, 100, 150 numbers. So they are becoming the firm sales orders, right? This is how this planning metal and the actual orders are linked, and how the sales orders are consuming the plan of the common material, the planning material, right? So again, I suggest you to go through the session 22, where we are this planning given, how strategy is getting consumed. And also I suggest you to practice this with the examples. And this toothpaste and the SKUs is a very simple example which I shared with you, so that you can understand the concept of planning metal and planning BYM. Based on your industry, based on your application, you can use the planning metal along with the right planning strategy like 63 or 50 or 52 based on your need. If you need any specific support, you can write to me in the email what is given in this this video. I can help you to set the right parameters. So in this session, we discuss about planning metal, how planning metal is linked with the individual actual materials, then what is the purpose of planning plant. In the next session, we'll discuss in detail about availability check parameters, which is very, very important parameter for any production planning and any commitment. Also give your feedback to improve the flow and contents of our course. Meanwhile, please visit our website www.vgrowin.com and suggest to your friends and colleagues to subscribe to our channel to have more knowledge sharing. Thank you all. See you in the next session. Bye.